Hello students, how are you all today? I hope you all are safe and enjoying the indoor vacation. I am Vishakha ma'am and I'll be teaching you science. Do you remember which chapter we were learning in our last sessions? Yes, we were learning about rocks and soil. So students, let's quickly recap our last sessions. Soil consists of many things such as water, dead plants and animals, fine clay, sand, mud, minerals and small pieces of rock. Then we learned about formation of soil. If you remember, due to the strong effect of sunlight, water and wind, big rocks break down into smaller pieces of rocks over a long period of time, and these rocks continue to break down further, and they keep on breaking till they become very fine particles called soil. Students, we have also learned about layers of soil, wherein we understood the contents of soil in layer form. So students, the lowest layer is bedrock, then small stones and pebbles, after that sand, clay and silt, and the topmost layer is topsoil. After that, we understood several uses of soil. As we know, soil provides water, minerals and other nutrients to plants for their growth. Soil is very important for plants and animals because our food comes from plants and plants grow in the soil. And also, we have learned that small animals live in the soil where they breathe air present in the soil and make the soil fertile. Students, if you remember, we also understood the concept of fertile soil. Fertile soil is the soil where plants grow well. If you remember, we have learned something regarding germs. Remember it? Yes, we have learned about colors of soil. Soils can be brown, yellow or red in color. Today, we are going to learn whether plants can grow without soil. And after that, we will discuss about exercise. Actually, soil is a precious gift of nature. With the help of roots, plants hold the soil and also prevent fertile soil from being blown away by water or strong wind. So, it is necessary to grow more and more plants to protect the soil. Now, let's see some words to know. So, first word is soil. What is soil? Soil is the topmost layer of the earth. Now, second word is fertile. What do you mean by fertile? The type of soil in which plants grow well. Now, third is topsoil. What is topsoil? The topmost layer of soil, that is the uppermost layer, is topsoil. Now, fourth is moisture. What do you mean by moisture? Moisture is very small amount of water that makes things slightly wet. Now students, let's start with the exercise. A. Filling the blanks. Number 1. The dash of a plant grows into the soil. What is the answer? The root of a plant grows into the soil. Second, soil contains only dash. Soil contains only rocks. Third, soil is formed by the breakdown of dash. Answer is, soil is formed by the breakdown of rocks. Fourth, dash makes the soil more fertile. Now, who makes the soil more fertile? Dead plants and animals make the soil more fertile. Fifth, we should dash trees to protect the topsoil. We should plant trees to protect the topsoil. Let's go to another section. Take the correct option. First, which of the following things does the soil provide to plants? A. Water. B. Nutrients. C. Minerals. D. All of these. The answer is D. All of these. Second, which of the following helps in the breakdown of rocks to form soil? A. Sunlight. B. Water. C. Glass. D. Both A and B. So, the answer is D. Both A and B. Both sunlight and water help in the breakdown of rocks to form soil. Third question, which of these is not true about soil? A. It takes a very long time to form soil. B. Soil is formed by the breakdown of rocks. C. Soil forms very quickly and easily. And D. Soil should be conserved. So, the answer is C. Soil forms very quickly and easily is not a true statement, because we have learned soil is formed over a long period of time. Let's go to another section. Answer the following questions. First, short question answers. In that, first question is, what is soil? The topmost layer of the earth is called soil. Second question, name the things which are mixed in the soil to make it fertile. So, the answer is, remains of dead plants and animals are mixed in the soil to make it fertile. Third question, why is the color of soil not the same everywhere? So, the answer is, different types of rocks are present in different areas which break down to form soil. As we have learned that if a region has black rock, it will have black color soil. Therefore, soil is not of same color everywhere. Fourth question, name three animals which live in soil. So, the answer is beetles, snails and earthworms live in soil. Fifth question, list the things that soil contains. So, what is the answer? The answer is soil contains air, water, dead plants and animals, fine sand, clay, minerals and small pieces of stones. Let's come to the long answer questions. First, how is soil formed? So, the answer is, as we have learned in our last session, soil is formed from rocks due to the strong effects of sunlight, water and wind. Big rocks break down into smaller pieces of rocks over a long period of time. These small pieces continue to break down further till they become very fine particles called soil. The breaking down of rocks into soil is a very slow process and takes a lot of time. While the rocks are being broken down, dead plants and animals get mixed with the small rock pieces, making them rich in nutrients and fertile. Now, second question. Why do plants need soil? Answer, plants grow in soil and give us fruits, vegetables, cereals and pulses. Soil provides water, minerals and other nutrients to plants for their growth. The roots of the plants absorb these things from the soil. Third question, list the different uses of soil. So, the different uses of soil are, first, plants grow in soil and give us fruits, vegetables, cereals and pulses. Soil provides water, minerals and other nutrients to plants for their growth. The roots of the plants absorb these things from the soil. Small animals such as beetles, ants, slugs, snails and the earthworms live in the soil and breathe air present in soil. some of these animals help to make the soil fertile? Fourth question, how do plants protect the soil? So, the answer is, plants hold the soil with their roots and prevent the fertile topsoil from being blown away by strong wind or water. Now, question 5. Draw a flowchart to show the process of soil formation. Students, how is soil formed? Step 1. Big pieces of rocks break down into smaller pieces of rocks by wind, rain and sunlight. And step 2. Big pieces of rocks continue to break down into even smaller pieces of rocks. Step 3. Dead remains of plants and animals mix with smaller pieces of rocks. And fourth step, very fine particles of soil are formed. So this is how soil is formed. Students, in this chapter, we have learned about formation of soil, contents of soil, colors of soil, and uses of soil.